In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Geometry free worksheet using similar polygons. Our directions are that the polygons in each pair are similar, so we're to find the missing side length. And remember, similar polygons, their sides are proportional. So in number one, let's call this missing side length x. So we're going to set up a proportion and then solve for x. This little side 10 is to the side x, as the smaller side 15 is to the larger side 24. And now we'll cross multiply. 10 times 24 is equal to x times 15. 10 times 24 is 240, and that's equal to 15x. Now in order to solve for x, we're going to divide by 15 in order to isolate that x. 15 divided by 15 is 1, and 1 times x is x. So 240 divided by 15 is the missing side length, and that is 16. And number two, the smaller base 12 over the missing side, call this y, is equal to the proportion of the smaller base 15 over the side 25. Since 12 corresponds to 15, and y corresponds to 25. Now we'll cross multiply. 12 times 25 equals y times 15. 12 times 25 equals 300, and 300 is equal to 15y. When I divide by 15, I'll get that y is equal to 20. So 20 is our missing side length for the trapezoid in number 2. And number three, 10 corresponds with the missing side length, and 8 corresponds with 4. So I'll do 10 over 8 equal to our missing side length. Let's call this A. Let's call this A over 4. Cross multiplying, 10 times 4 equals 8 times A. 40 equals 8. A, since 10 times 4 is 40, and when I divide by 8, I get that 5 is equal to A. So the missing side length in number 3 is 5. In number 4, our missing length, let's call this X, corresponds to 5. And 12 corresponds to 6. So we'll write X over 12 equal to 5 over 6. When we cross multiply, x times 6 will equal 12 times 5. So 6x equals 12 times 5, which is 60. And when I divide by 6, I get that x is equal to 10. So 10 is the missing side length in number 4. In number 5, notice that our indicated side, let's call this r, is shorter than 6. So r will correspond with 10. So we'll have r over some number equal to 10 over some number. And then this side length of 6, so r over 6, that side length 6 corresponds to 12, 10 over 12. Then we'll cross multiply. R times 12 equals 6 times 10. So 12r is equal to 60. And when I divide by 12, I'll get that r is equal to 60 divided by 12, which is 5. So that missing side length is 5. And lastly in this video, I'll go over number 6. We can see that the longest side, 54, over the shortest side, let's call this side x, is proportional to the longer side, 63, over the shorter side, 35. And we know that those are proportional because these are similar polygons. So when we cross multiply, we'll do 54 times 35, and that's going to be equal to 63 times x. 54 times 35 is 1,890, and that's equal to 63x. When we divide by 63, we'll isolate the x to get that 1,890 divided by 63 is 30, and 30 is equal to x. So 30 is our solution in number 6. Join me in the next video where I'll complete numbers 7 through 14. If you haven't already, click that subscribe button, give me a thumbs up, and comment below.